everybody, to another presentation of the NBA live on 2K Sports. We'll watch the Boston Celtics in this one as they go up against the Toronto Raptors. With two Hall of Famers, Doris Burke and Grant Hill, I'm Brian Anderson. Allie LaForce, our reporter. Allie, it's all yours.
Well, Fred VanVleet, a first-time All-Star in 2021, said of his journey, quote, "It's like a movie storyline, just scratching and clawing, all the work and the sacrifices. I'm always going to have this great perspective that allows me to navigate differently and helps me succeed." Brian?
Allie, his toughness and IQ, a big factor for them. Thanks for that. And we're expecting an intense battle in the front court tonight, Grant. Both teams with a lot of talent in those positions.
You know, B.A., it'll be an interesting matchup here with the talent and size of their front court. It should make this game extra challenging for these squads. They can't just count on being the dominant force down low. They'll have to get a little creative.
Now let's take a look at Toronto's starting lineup. Trent Jr. and Anunoby out on the wings. Barnes and Siakam serve as the big men as they go small. And it's VanVleet in at the one. And for Boston, Tatum and Horford at the forward slots. Smart and Brown, a great defensive backcourt. And it's Williams in at the center position. Oh, it's blocked by Williams. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Williams. And that shot was going nowhere thanks to that aggressive swat.
And that kind of rejection early on energizes your squad. The coaching staff just loves this kind of hustle.
Boston on D.
Boy, a miss like that will drive any scorer crazy, especially with the defender giving a cushion.
Smart passes to Horford. Uses the glass on the layup.
Well, this guy's such a polished player from this area of the floor. Al Horford, it doesn't get any easier than that one right there. When you watch him play, you can feel the effect that Marcus Smart has on a basketball game. Defensively, this guy is as good as any guard in the league, and he has multiple all-defensive selections to show for it.
Here's Smart. The Raptors making their last shot. Kick out to Brown. The three is up. Barnes with the rebound. The Raptors have gone 1-for-3 so far. Pass to Trent. VanVleet on the wing. Back to Trent from behind the arc. He buries it from three. The defensive player of the year in 2022, Doris Marcus Smart. His defense sets the tone for this team.
It does, B.A. There's no doubt about it. They feed off both his energy and his attitude. There are so many little things that Marcus Smart does that can get into the head of opposing ball handlers. He pressures the basketball. He'll get strip steals. He can also pinch down in the post and give some assistance to a big man. The effect on winning is real.
Now here's VanVleet. Siakam outside. Over Williams. Oh, it's blocked by Williams. Smart passes to Tatum. Lets the three fly. Toronto grabs the miss.
Just terrible defense. I don't know how he missed that shot.
Pass to VanVleet. Siakam left side. Over Williams. Siakam no good. Boston has gone 0-for-3 from downtown. Brown with it. And that one goes in as he's fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts the free throw.
Boy, when you think about Jaylen Brown, you have to be impressed by the progress he has made offensively. He's become one of those guys that you know wants to take it to the next level.
One shot.
Free throw, no good for Brown. And how about Jaylen Brown, Doris, becoming an offensive monster?
This guy has become a consistent three-point shooting threat. He can knock down shots from the field. He can go off the bounce. He'll contribute on the backboards. And we know they challenged him to become a better playmaker, and he has. He has become the full package.
And now it seems Siakam is in his prime. How do you see his place in the league, Grant?
Well, I really like him, but he seems to be an elite second option. Not sure if you want to build an entire offense around him, but certainly has proven to be an important piece to a championship-level team.
First one falls for him.
Sometimes it's hard to believe looking at him now, but Pascal Siakam was drafted late in the first round back in 2016. Think about it. This was the 27th pick at one point.
So he hits one of two from the stripe. And you can bet a lot of teams are kicking themselves now for not selecting Siakam.
Well, you have to be able to see what the potential in the future is. And Pascal Siakam has morphed into a highly productive offensive player. And the key here, guys, is there's still much room for growth. He gets more and more dangerous by the year.
The Raptors with a lead. Barnes against Brown. Ananobi passes to Barnes. Shot clock at five. And here's Van Vliet from the arc. No luck on that one. And Boston going the other way now. Smart outside. And we're just over 3.5 minutes into this first quarter. Williams, a screen on Van Vliet. Smart for three. Boston, no good that time either. The Raptors have gone 2 for 7, a sluggish start. Siakam, the pass to Barnes. Now here's Van Vliet. Ananobi on the wing. Back to Van Vliet. Williams against Barnes. Ananobi for three. Williams grabs the board. Boston trailing. Smart outside. Pass to Brown. Boston, no good that time either. Toronto has gone 1 for 3 from beyond the arc. Here's Siakam. Williams grabs the board. Williams has got 4 rebounds now. Here's Brown. And Brown with the stuff!
Don't you love how Brown just barrels into the teeth of the defense? This is a shifty forward who knows how to get to the rack.
Now here's Siakam. Barnes with a screen on Williams. And here's Siakam for three. The shot, no good. Tie game in Boston. We've got more in store for you right after this. And if you're just joining us, it's been a pretty even game through the first quarter. All right, guys, what do you think about the Celtics here in this one?
The aggressiveness on defense has been infectious. Everyone's come to the party. I love it.
Well, I think they combined great intelligence with great effort, and you can see the results.
Here's Pritchard.
And you have to think that one advantage this Celtics team has is a deep roster. Lots of quality guys they can assemble different ways. They're pretty adaptable.
Tatum and Williams are your small and power forwards. Peyton Pritchard is out there with Malcolm Brogdon. And it's Williams in at the five, roaming the paint. That's who's in the game for the Celtics. Now here's Van Vliet. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Oh, it's blocked by Williams. Here's Pritchard. Jacks up a three. Achua with a rebound.
You know, a versatile bench really is a gift for the Celtics in tough situations.
And even a great starting five isn't perfect against every opponent. It's important to have flexibility, and that's something that Boston definitely has.
Oh, it's blocked by Williams.
Out of bounds as Toronto keeps possession.
Griffin, he's checked in for Williams.
Starting the second quarter, about a minute gone. Just five on the clock. Porter, the pass to Achua. The kick out to Van Vliet. Achua with a screen on Brogdon. And Blake Griffin is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul. The Celtics making a switch here. White's checked in. Pass to Flynn. On the wing, Porter. Birch with a screen on Tatum. Porter, the pass to Birch. And Blake Griffin is going to pick up the foul. That'll be a second foul of the game. Over the last few years, we've seen the rise of the skilled big. Doris, how's that changed the way basketball is played?
I think, B.A., certainly it has made for a more wide-open game. The advent of that stretch four, stretch five, it creates better spacing because you've got to deal with their shooting. To me, it's a much better product for the fans.
Clock at four. Achua with a screen on Tatum.
And again, no good by Toronto. Boston's gone 0-for-2 from outside in the second quarter. And from the sideline, let's catch up with Allie.
Thanks. Well, Jason Tatum added muscle to his frame and layers to his game, but still not satisfied. He said, quote, "I just got to be better. I have to elevate my level from being one of the top 10 to 15 players to a top 5 player. I got to make everybody else around me better." Brian, still work to do.
And plenty of runway to do it, Allie. Thanks.
That's his shot, and one I'm sure he wants back.
I think when people think of Malcolm Brogdon, the first word that comes to mind is consistency. This guy takes quality shots. He's already produced a 50-40-90 season back in 2019. Boy, when he's this deep, it's going to be tough to stop him, especially with a smaller defender.
Van Vliet on the wing. And we're just over 2.5 minutes into the second. Sinks that one after missing his first two attempts. Now 1-for-3. Well, that 50-40-90 season put Brogdon in pretty exclusive company, Doris.
It sure did, B.A. Only the 8th player in the history of the league to accomplish that feat. Think about it. It takes tremendous skill to carry those percentages, the discipline to take good shots, the work required to become a consistent shooter. Brogdon brings it every game.
Here's Tatum. And too long on the shot. For Toronto, they've gone 1-for-6 in the second quarter. Not great.
Van Vliet against Brogdon. Van Vliet right side.
For three. And Van Vliet again missing.
And he almost made them regret defending him so loosely.
To the paint. Double team on Brogdon. On the wing, Tatum. Guarded by Young.
And Young with the block.
Here's Flynn.
Still getting warmed up offensively.
No buckets yet in the game from him.
Pass to Porter.
Screen by Young. Right side, Porter.
And that misses. That would have put him up.
Brogdon against Van Vliet.
Stolen by Van Vliet.
Here's Flynn. Got a hand on it.
That's anticipation on the defensive end by Derek White. Send it back, young sir.
Griffin passes to Brogdon. There's 31 seconds left in the first half of basketball. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Fires the three. Rebound by the Raptors. Achua's got four rebounds in the game. Tatum against Porter. Young, the pass to Van Vliet. Achua with a screen on Brogdon. Tie game in Boston. And we'll step away briefly, but get you right back out there for the start of the third quarter, right after the break. And we've got second half action for you. Thus far, a pretty evenly contested game. And for Boston, they're shooting a rough 25% for the field in this game.
And guys, so many great players coming out of Canada. The Raptors have converted a nation, not just watching basketball, but to playing it as well.
Second half underway. Here's who Nick Nurse has got on the floor. Barnes and Siakam serve as the big men as they go small. Trent Jr. and Anunoby out on the wings. And it's Van Vliet in at the point. Toronto trailing. Van Vliet outside. Siakam right side. And the foul is called. He missed it, so he's got a couple of free throws coming his way. And Grant, you think back to those early Raptors jerseys with the big dinosaur. They admit it was aimed at the kids.
Yeah, of course. I mean, rather than win over the older hockey fans, they went after the younger generation. And now they're all grown up and packing the seats.
Shooting two.
That's good from Siakam. No team has had to make more sacrifices than Toronto during the pandemic.
You are right about that, BA. I mean, they had to change their home base to Tampa. In essence, they spent an entire season on the road. It was tough for everyone, but the Raptors faced some big challenges.
Siakam hits them both.
Boy, when you think about the Boston Celtics and their fans, I think one thing that makes them unique, it isn't just the state of Massachusetts, right? It's the entire region of New England.
Now here's Smart. Boy, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Williams, and a great assist by Brown as that one goes in. And the Celtics lead by three. Siakam against Williams. Here's Barnes. Oh, and a vicious dunk by Barnes.
Well, the beauty of Pascal Siakam's game, he's still growing, and the guy is so unselfish.
Yeah, Doris, if you're anywhere in the northeast portion of the U.S., you're going to see a lot of Boston jerseys.
Well, Maine, New Hampshire, Vermont, Rhode Island, they all adopt the Celtics as their hometown team. But here's what's even more impressive, BA. Go to any NBA city, any of the other 29 cities, and you are going to see Celtic green jerseys. That is a fan base that travels well.
Here's Smart. Trent with a double. Smart passes to Williams. Brown with it. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two. It's going to go on Gary Trent.
You get a look at the gritty, competitive fire of Jaylen Brown. Takes on the defense and draws the contact.
That free throw misses.
And for Jaylen Brown at the free throw line, he has worked so hard on his mechanics, and that's paid dividends in terms of his confidence, guys.
And the second free throw is good. Well, Doris, it was only a few years ago that the Raptors won an NBA title.
It seems like a lot further back, though.
It does, B.A., because we're looking at a much different basketball team. Obviously, Kawhi Leonard has moved on. Kyle Lowry has moved on. In fact, many of the key players from that squad have moved on. Incredible to think they have managed to remain competitive.
Here's Siakam. And we're about a minute and a half in the second half. Horford pulls it in. The Celtics with the lead.
When you think about Al Horford at his best, he is one of the league's most versatile big men. This guy is a very strong passer. He can defend across positions, including switching out on the perimeter, and he can knock down open threes.
Now here's Tatum. That one drops for him. And the Celtics lead by four.
Once Jason Tatum has the ball in his hands in the painted area, this guy will power through. He'll put it up and over you if necessary. He knows how to score it.
Siakam against Williams. Siakam right side. The shot no good. Some solid defense from Williams. And it may have taken 10 years, but Horford's defense finally got recognized in 2018.
Yeah, he made the NBA's all-defensive team that season, B.A., and he may not be a shot-blocking force like some of the great defensive players in this league, but there isn't a weakness to his game on the defensive end.
Now here's Brown. Give him eight. Connects on the foul line jumper. Now it's a six-point Celtic lead.
Well, the mid-range is something Jaylen Brown entered the NBA with. He looks very comfortable in that spot.
Van Vliet, the pass to Ananobi. And the Raptors miss again. The Celtics have gotten four of their first five shots to go since the break. Van Vliet against Smart. Horford, left side. Smart passes to Brown. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair. Well, Grant, you look at the Celtics and their defense. Not a surprise, it's at the heart of this team.
No question. I mean, you have three-plus defenders on the perimeter. Their big men can switch on the guards and protect the rim, too. Top to bottom, they can match up well with any team.
No good on that one. Some changes for Boston. Griffin, he's checked in for Williams. Brogdon comes in for Tatum. And Pritchard is subbed in for Smart. Birch, he's checked in for Toronto. Boucher comes in for Scotty Barnes. Good on the second one. For Toronto, they've gotten just one of five shots to drop since halftime. Boy, they'd love if anyone could get a bucket.
Yeah, their offense has been grinding to a halt.
Ananobi can't get it to go.
Defense dodged a bullet that time. Total breakdown.
Just over 3.5 minutes through the third. Now Brown. He's got 11. Six to shoot. Down low. And there's Horford on the assist by Brown. Horford's got his second basket.
I love it when Al Horford is challenging defenders to stay with him. Use your physicality, big man.
And Toronto calls time here. Williams has checked in for Boston. To the inside. Pass to Birch. Van Vliet outside. There's a screen by Birch. Clock at 6. Van Vliet misses.
And you just can't afford to give up that kind of look very often.
Griffin passes to Brown. Shoots over Ananobi. The bank shot, no good. Toronto has gotten nothing to fall from outside in this third quarter. Van Vliet outside. 34 seconds left in the third.
Boy, this guy is a good finisher, so he misses a chippy. That's tough to take.
Pass to Brown. There's 18 seconds left to play in the third quarter here. Late clock. The Celtics got to hurry here. The shot. And he gets the jumper to drop. And it's an 11-point Boston lead.
And, guys, increasingly we've seen Jaylen Brown willing to shoulder the offensive burden, and, boy, the ability just blossoming.
And so it's the Boston Celtics. They lead by 11 as the quarter comes to a close. A big difference in shooting percentages. That's why they lead. More NBA on 2K Sports right after this. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm assist of the game.
You know, I'm kind of stoked this was a choice because I love this pass. A remarkable find. He put his court vision on full display.
Well, making the game easy for your teammates, all about putting them in a position to score. That's pretty.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may already be out of hand. Horford and Williams together in the front court. Brogdon and Brown are on the wings. And it's Smart in at the one. That's who's in the game for the Celtics. And there's the call on Al Horford. That's his first foul of the game. Van Vliet, the pass to Siakam. Achua with a screen on Williams. Pass to Achua. Five to shoot. That drops. And it comes off an assist from Siakam. Siakam's got three assists now in this one. The Celtics with the lead. Smart outside. Here's Brown. There's the three. Siakam pulls down the board. Trent outside. Pass to Achua. Now Van Vliet. Defended by Smart. Looking to get back on track. Rebounded by the Celtics. Horford's got a rebound number five here tonight. Brown against Barnes. Outside, Brown. Six on the shot clock. Rejected by Barnes.
Send it back, Scotty Barnes. Show off that defensive acumen.
About a minute and a half through the fourth quarter now. Trent. Some solid defense from Williams. Boston's shooting just 38%. Their offense not where they want to be. Smart outside. Shoots off the step back, and there's Brown. That one's good. On the assist by Horford.
Well, that's where you use your athleticism and agility if you're Jaylen Brown, navigating to a high percentage look.
And the Raptors call time here. And now we present our New Balance player of the game, Jaylen Brown.
Just a dominant force for them on the offensive end tonight. I mean, stepping up big when his team needed, being able to gather a big share of their points. It's safe to say this game would have been a rough one for them without him in the mix.
And you know, this home arena really appreciates this guy. And it's clear that he takes pride in playing his best in front of them. Time now to hear from our reporter, Allie LaForce.
I was able to listen in on what Nick Nurse had to say to the team. It wasn't feel-good pep talk. He wants them to show some fight in the closing moments. He told them, if you guys want to salvage any respect from this game, now's the time to do it. Show them we are better than this. Guys, take it away.
Okay, thank you, Allie. And the basket by Van Vliet. For Boston, they've gotten just one shot to fall out of three attempts in the fourth. The drive by Brogdon. Outside Tatum, fires the three, and good. Coming on the assist by Brogdon. And the Celtics lead by 12.
Boy, from the moment he entered the league, Jason Tatum has proven to be a knockdown three-point shooter. Huge asset for his team.
Now here's Siakam. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take two free throws. Robert Williams picks up one.
Heady play to stop that easy layup right there. I mean, make him earn it at the line.
Take a break. Two shots.
And he makes a first.
Boy, the evolution of Pascal Siakam has been such a pleasure to watch. The work ethic is commendable, and he's learning how to be a leader, guys.
Anunoby, he's checked in for Porter Jr. And so he makes both from the line. Just over 2.5 minutes played now. Final quarter of regulation. Tatum against Anunoby. And it's Tatum missing. For Toronto, they've gotten half of their attempts to fall in the fourth. 2 for 4 now. Siakam, the pass to Barnes. Can't get it to drop. Some solid defense from Williams. Tatum with it. And it's Anunoby picking him up. From deep. And it's Tatum missing. Tatum's got 1 3-pointer tonight so far in 4 tries. And he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for 2. That's on Al Horford.
Well, with that 6'9" length, right? Siakam uses those long limbs to create contact, get himself some free throws. Nicely done.
Shooting 2.
First free throw is good, and that brings him within single digits. Brown, he's checked in for Malcolm Brogdon. Siakam hits them both. Boston's gone 1 for 3 in the fourth quarter from range. Outside Tatum. Williams, a screen on Anunoby. Here's Tatum. So it'll be 2 free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting.
Well, you like the level of aggression right there from Jason Tatum. Committed to scoring on the interior and draws the contact.
On the first, and that'll put him up by 9.
What impresses me about Jason Tatum are his work habits, his commitment in the offseason to adding something else to his arsenal. We know he can play high-level basketball on both ends. The sky is the limit.
And so Tatum nails both of them. 1:33 left in the fourth. Barnes with a screen on Williams. And here's Siakam for 3. He can't get that one to fall. And Boston going the other way now. Smart against Van Vliet. Pass to Brown. Horford, a screen on Trent. Here's Brown. And the jam by Brown.
And a comfortable win for them here. Game is out of reach. Time for the fans now to celebrate a win for the Celtics.
And at first glance, it appeared to be an easy win for them. However, they had to weather some storms along the way, Grant.
Yeah, in terms of competitiveness, it was a lot closer than the final score indicates.
And what a huge performance it was for Jaylen Brown.
What you love about his performance is that he is simply taking what the defense allows and then making the most of his opportunities.
Now here's Brown. Out of bounds, it'll go to the Raptors. So Boston going with almost an entire new group here. Griffin, he's checked in for Williams. Williams comes in for Horford. White, he's checked in for Tatum. And Pritchard is subbed in for Smart. A big group substitution here for Toronto. Birch, he's checked in for Siakam. Young comes in for Scotty Barnes. Porter Jr., he's checked in for Anunoby. And it's Flynn in for Van Vliet. 3 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Williams with the screen. White for 3. Porter pulls it in. Here's Flynn. Off on that one. So we see the Celtics taking the W here.
A competitive game. You have to feel like this crowd gave him a little extra edge.
Yeah, they really fed off the energy. You saw their activity level go up. Just a tremendous performance.
All right, now let's check in with Allie LaForce. Allie, what do you have?
Thank you very much. Jalen, you had it going. Can you talk about the confidence you had tonight?
I'm just trying to continue to show people what I can do, continue to get better. It's a long journey. It's a process. I still got a long way to go and a lot to learn. So I'm going to just keep going up.
It's all part of the journey. Thanks, Jalen.
Thanks, Allie. Great interview once again. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Doris Burke, Allie LaForce in Grand Hill, and all of our crew, this is Brian Anderson thanking you for watching this 2K Sports presentation of the NBA. We'll see you next time.